स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज कामेश्वरी फ्रॉम नल्ला नरसिंहारेड्डी एजुकेशन सोसाइटी ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस माय सब्जेक्ट वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट इन दैट वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वी आर इन सेकंड यूनिट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सॉइल एरोजन एंड इट्स control measures in this chapter we already discussed different methods that is terracing mulching and contour techniques and different types of soil erosion techniques how to control soil erosion these are the different ways we are discussed in previous classes how to control soil erosion first of all what is soil erosion over a period of time rainfall comes from the atmosphere to ground surface so some of the water will be infiltrated into the ground surface remaining water will be stagnant on a ground surface so that water will be over a period of time so that will be flooded on a ground surface that will reaches to due to that erosion soil particles also eroded so form a soil erosion how to reduce that soil erosion to reduce soil erosion by we can cover the overall land by vegetation so vegetation covers the advantage is the overall land utilized by using plantation due to that overall area covered by vegetation and due to that erosion will be reduced infiltration will be increased and also that water will be utilized for drinking water and the vegetation purpose and the plantation purpose and animal purpose also so that is called as soil erosion now and soil erosion we can reduce by using different ways by mulching terracing and gully control different ways we can reduce the soil erosion now the today's topic is important ways of enriching damaged soils so what is the meaning of the enriched damaged soils these are divided into different types so that is mulching green manuring cover cropping and composting vermi composting green belt development and remaining things also there so first of all what is meant by importance ways of enriching damaged soils so the enriching damaged soils are the fertility of the soil is maintained by the presence of vegetation the fertility of the soil is maintained by the presence of vegetation that forms a protective cover over the soil the nutrient cycle helps to maintain the fertility of the soil the nutrient cycle helps to maintain the fertility of the soil so water helps the nutrients to enter the soil plant roots absorb the nutrients present in the soil so plant roots absorb the nutrients that are present in the soil and when the leaves falls the insects worms and other decomposers decompose the leaves and return the nutrients to the soil so the leaves falls on a ground surface though that form a insects and worms and other decomposers decompose the leaves and return the nutrients to the soil and these are the different methods for enrichment can be accomplished in the following ways that are mulching green manuring cover cropping compositing and green belt development and two more will be there so first we can discuss what is mulching what is meant by mulching so in this method organic matter is applied to the soil surface so organic is organic matter is applied to the soil surface to conserve soil moisture to conserve the soil moisture prevent surface compaction reduce runoff so we can apply organic matter to the soil surface, so conserve the soil moisture and also prevent the compaction, reduce the runoff and erosion of topsoil, and also control of weeds, insult the soil, reduce weeds, add nutrients to soil and encourage the growth of beneficial soil flora and fauna. Increase the soil flora and fauna. And also these mulching are two types. What are the two types? Are organic mulching and inorganic mulches. These are discussed in previous class also. What are the organic mulches comes under? What are the organic mulches and inorganic mulches? The organic mulches include wood chips, shaving. So in this mulches are two types, that are organic mulches and inorganic mulches. That are organic mulches include wood chips, shaving and cocoa bean, crushed corn crops, grass chipping, leaves, manure, newspaper, peat, pine needles, scrubbed bark chips, straw, raw wood fiber. Inorganic mulches include clay aggregates, weed barrier fabrics, recycled rubber tires, gravel, stone pebbles, etc. These are comes under organic mulches and inorganic mulches. What are the examples of organic mulches are? That are wood chips, Coca-Cola, cocoa bean hulls, crushed corn cobs, leaves, manure and newspaper. And the comes under inorganic mulches include clay aggregates, weed barrier fabrics and recycled rubber tiles. And next one, green manuring. The green manuring is the practice of growing green manure crops. What are the growing manure crops are? Examples: wheat, radish, carrot, pea, beans, to cover the bare soil. So these are the manure crops. Examples are wheat, rubbish, carrot, and to cover the bare soil. So they inhibit the growth of weeds and their root prevents soil erosion. They inhibits the growth of weeds and their roots prevent soil erosion. The soil surface is protected from compaction by rainfall. The soil surface is protected from compaction by rainfall. These plants encourage the growth of beneficial insects. Examples: ground beetles. And what is cover cropping? The cover cropping are live green legumes have been used successfully as a cover crop. So legumes have been used successfully as a cover crop. They help to control the growth of weeds, improve the soil organic matter and nutrient status, prevent soil erosion and do not compete with the crop for resources. So here we are discussing mulching and green manuring and cover cropping. First of all, what is the importance of enriching damaged soils? The enriching damaged soils, they are of the soil is maintaining by the presence of vegetation that forms a protective cover over the soil. So it reduces the soil erosion, increase the infiltration losses. So that root zone capability of holds the soil. And the nutrient cycle helps to maintain the fertility of the soil, that fertility of the soil. Water helps to nutrients to enter the soil. Water helps to nutrients to enter the soil. And what is meant by mulching means it is organic matter is applied to the soil surface to conserve the soil moisture, prevent soil compaction and also reduce the runoff and erosion losses, and also erosion of the topsoil and control of weeds. And what is green mulching? And mulches are divided into two types. One is organic and inorganic. And green mulching are examples are aloe area growing by using manure crops. What are they meant by manure crops means? That means radish, wheat, carrot. And this type of are examples of growing green. They inhibit the growth of weeds and roots prevent the soil erosion. The soil surface is protected from compaction by rainwater. So these plants encourage the growth of beneficial insects. Example, ground beetles. Thank you.